class. Today we are going to analyze a accessible building on STAAD.Pro with combination load. So I first open STAAD.Pro, click on new project, click on space, you can give a name and location, click on meter and kilometer, then click on next. Okay. Then click on add beam, or you can go to structure wizard, then finish. It will be a frame model and it will be frame bay frame. The length will be 16 meter for 4 rooms divided into 4. The height will be 3 meter. The width will be 18 meter for 6 rooms. So per room will be 3 meter. The height is 1. Okay, for single floor. Then click on apply. We have that building, so close it to merge into STAAD.Pro. Then click on yes. X, Y, and Z that dimension will be 000. Then click on OK. At first, you have to create a slab of this building. We are going to draw a slab by generate surface machine. Click on generate surface machine and select the corner nodes of the building. Just click on the corner nodes. Okay, it is a quadrantal machine, so click on quadrantal machine, then click on OK. Length is 16 meter, so division will be 4. Length is 18 meter, division is 6. As we created, the length per length is 3 meter. 16, it will be 4, and for 18 it will be 6. Then click on apply. You can check by red cursor the total building has been converted into different slabs. Okay. Now you have to support the columns. Okay. For that, go to front view. Okay. Go to support. Create a support. It will be fixed support. So click fixed and click on add. Select the support and select the foundation of the columns of the building by node cursor. Select the nodes, or you can go to property. At first we give the property, you will see advantage in later. Okay, go to property, go to define. It will be rectangular. Column will be 500 millimeter by 500 millimeter, so 0.5 by 0.5. then click on add. Beams will be 0.35 by 0.35. then click on add. Now assign the property into the building. Select the column property, select the columns by select beam parallels to y axis and click on assign to selected beams and click on assign. Then yes. Click on beam property. Now select the beam by select beam parallel to x and select beam parallel to z, and then assign to selected node beams, then assign, then yes. And for the beam, we go to thickness. Click on thickness. It will be 0.2 for 200 millimeter. Then click on add, then close. Now select the slabs by plate cursor. Select the slabs, select the plate thickness, click on assign to selected plates, then assign it, then yes. Now we are going to copy the property in y direction. It will be a 6-7 storied building, So we are going to copy it in 7 storied. Okay. So go to geometry cursor by selecting all the properties. Okay. Now go to front view, select the property. Now we are going to copy by transitional repeat. In y axis will be 7 storied, spacing will be 3 meter, and click on OK. As you can see, all the properties we given in one floor has been copied in the 7 floor. You can check on the 3D render view. See, all the property are copied. For this reason, we don't give the support property on the column. Now we give the support property. Okay, go to support page. I have created support. So select node cursor and select the nodes and click on assign to selected nodes, then yes. Now you see all the properties and support has been given. Now it's time to give load. So go to load page, click on load case detail, click on add. Loading type will be dead. Time, give a title dead, click on add, and live, give title live, then add, then close. Go to dead load. In dead load it will be a self weight, member load, and load load. Click the safe load, factor will be -1 in the y direction, then click on add. Member load will be -10 kN/m, click on add. Flow load will be -4 kN/m². And you have to define the y range. What is y range? Y range is minimum 4 distance in from the y direction to maximum 4 distance to y direction in the y direction. So minimum 4 is here. So I will click on the node and you can have the dimension of in y direction, it is 3, and the maximum distance of the floor is here. So click on the node and it is 24. So minimum 3, maximum 24. Then click on add, then close it. Click on self weight, it goes to all the building, all the structure, all the members. Click on assign to view for assigning the whole structure. Click on member load and select the members by select beam parallel to X and select beam parallel to Z. Okay, now just assign to selected beams. Assign yes. Okay, dead loads are assigned. Now it's time live load. Click on live. Add in the live load, just will add floor load. It will be -2 for residential building. Define y range. Y range is same 3 to 24. Then click on add, then close. Okay. Live load is also given. Now I have to combine the loading. For that, go to command, go to loading, go to load combination. The factor will be 1.5 for dead load and live load, and available loads are dead and live. For combination load, click on that and click on add, and you have the combination load of dead and live. The factor is 1.5 and close it, and you have the combination loads for dead and live. Okay, now you have to analyze it. For that, go to comments, analyze, perform analyze, no print, okay, analyze, run analyze, save. If there is no error, no warning, then you have all the right things. You have done all the right things on the analysis. So as you can see, there is no error, no warning. So we have done a perfect analysis and click on done. Okay, so that's it. That is how you're gonna analyze a RC building. Okay, so in the next class we are going to find out the reinforcement of the column, beams and slabs. So keep watching on my channel. Okay, and thank you for watching my video.